Hi, my name is James Jones. I'm a dean of students at Slade Middle School in New Britain, Connecticut. I graduated from New Britain High. I went to school throughout New Britain, graduated from Central Connecticut State University. I have a degree in psychology and youth counseling, and I have been working at Slade Middle School for 21 years. That was just to let students know that we lived here, we made it, and they can do it too. So it's like an inspirational thing so that they're reminded every day that we were in their shoes and we are successful. When I was 14, I started doing a child development program here at the high school where we ran a preschool for youth here. And I noticed right away that I made a connection with kids looking up to me, following instructions immediately, and looking for leadership, and I was an African-American male in that position, so it was great. I feel like a lot of our students have trust issues growing up in the educational system, and that has a lot to do with why they steer clear away from being educators. I think if they had great educators and made connections, that would encourage them to be educators. So that's why I feel like this job is important to us, because it maybe I'll make a connection with a student that says, you know what, I want to be that kind of person when I grow up and have the same connection as Mr. Jones did with his students. So I'm more of a person who likes a challenge, and I'll take on any challenge, but I understand where they're coming from, because the first adolescent years are the core years of any child's educational connection. So any connection they make with education, it's usually in the first 5 years. And I can see a lot of people wanting someone who is similar to them teaching their children, or has the same values as they have teaching their children. So I understand why they steer a lot of people away from that age group, because they feel like, you know, their kids are going to be developed by the time they get into sixth grade and already understand what their goals are for their children. Well, I think teacher cadet programs need to happen a little more in school districts, where, you know, we have male teachers, and it doesn't matter if they're black or white, but I feel like you need to have teachers making a connection with these young students and letting them know how to become a teacher, the benefits you have to becoming a teacher, even break down the salary of in the summers and the time off. I think kids are afraid that they're not good enough leaders. They don't have the confidence to be leaders. And I feel like if they made a connection and had a great mentor, that they would be okay being a leader in the classroom, teaching people. Because some of them are leaders. A lot of them are leaders in a negative way, but they have great leadership skills. And if we can just gear those skills to positivity, I feel like those students would be great leaders. And I always say, hey, you're a great leader. Let's be a positive leader when I see a leader, because they're easy to point out. Yeah, there is. So what the teacher cadet program is they prepare the students with their early learning center. And then once those students finish a semester, lesson planning, engaging with the preschoolers, and executing their lessons, they graduate and they get to team up with the teacher in their field. So if they want to be a social studies teacher, math teacher, whatever need be, whatever they want to be, Ms. Gainley teams them up with the teacher, and they shadow the teacher for the day. And they do it a couple of times during the school year. And at the end of the year, they do a lesson and they teach the lesson to the students. Well, I think teacher cadet programs need to happen a little more in school districts, where, you know, we have male teachers, and it doesn't matter if they're black or white, but I feel like you need to have teachers making a connection with these young students and letting them know how to become a teacher, the benefits you have to becoming a teacher, even break down the salary of in the summers and the time off. I think kids are afraid that they're not good enough leaders. They don't have the confidence to be leaders. And I feel like if they made a connection and had a great mentor, that they would be okay being a leader in the classroom, teaching people. Because some of them are leaders. A lot of them are leaders in a negative way, but they have great leadership skills. And if we can just gear those skills to positivity, I feel like those students would be great leaders. And I always say, hey, you're a great leader. Let's be a positive leader when I see a leader, because they're easy to point out. Yeah, there is. So what the teacher cadet program is they prepare the students with their early learning center. And then once those students finish a semester, lesson planning, engaging with the preschoolers, and executing their lessons, they graduate and they get to team up with the teacher in their field. So if they want to be a social studies teacher, math teacher, whatever need be, whatever they want to be, Ms. Gainley teams them up with the teacher and they shadow the teacher for the day. And they do it a couple of times during the school year. And at the end of the year, they do a lesson and they teach the lesson to the students. Absolutely.
Have you been affected by
that? Absolutely. You know, when our students look for success, they look in the community and they look on TV and whatever those, you know, adults are doing, that's who they gear towards. So a lot of African-American men are either athletes, rappers, and making tons of money, and kids are looking at those students or athletes as positive role models and gearing themselves to, oh, I want to play hard like him so I can make this kind of money. I feel like if teachers made the same connection and we had a draft for teachers and, you know, the highest paid teachers got, you know, the best teachers got the highest paid salary, kids would jump on that gravy train also, you know? Right. Well, connections. Everything is involved around relationships. Every student needs to have one adult that they can connect with. If this was my world, I would have every teacher mentor a student, and that would be part of your job description, to mentor that student, do some activity with the student at least twice a month. When I was a kid, I had great mentors in this community, and I took in everything that they taught me. And I looked at the community and learned a lot from the community also. I worked in a supermarket. I learned how people would just spend all their food stamps at the beginning of the month and struggle at the end of the month. So that's taught me early on, like, you need to self-sustain and budget, like, if you're not on food stamps. So when I got out of college and I got my own place, I set aside a certain amount of money every week, and that's what I was going to spend on groceries or whatever, $50 on shoes or whatever, and $50 on grocery. So I learned, you know, sitting in the supermarket on that aspect of, and then, you know, I had people in my neighborhood who would get their lights get cut off every now and then. Our lights, same thing. Everyone would share a plug. So I learned that people weren't budgeting for that, and that there are so many resources out here available, like energy assistance programs that people don't know about. So when I was a kid at 14, I worked for an energy assistance program in the summer, and I learned so much about it that I took that on and locked it in my head. So when I have families that are struggling, it's another resource that I have available for them. Everything I learned in this community, I either am teaching it to my students or teaching it to their parents. So if there are struggles, I can identify with them and I can get them to the necessary agencies and providers in the community. I serve on a lot of not-for-profit boards in our town so that I make those connections, and I still know, okay, so where does a parent go if they're being abused? You know, I know that the Prudence Crandall Center, because I'm on a board that funds them. You know, I'm learning everything about this community so I can be a community support service, and I give parents booklets on what agencies are available for food, for housing, for clothing. It's very important that they trust someone in our school. And I love being that person because, yes, I'll see them in a supermarket. I'll see them at their kids' sporting event. I'll see them, you know, anywhere in the community, and I'm always available for them 24 hours a day. Absolutely. We need a mentoring program for those young men. I'll be honest, every young Black male looks for an older Black male for a role model. Even if it's in a distance 80 miles away from you, I'm just watching you every day. They're looking for your role so that they can model it for themselves, because a lot of them don't have a dad, you know, to model that role for them. I can't tell you how many kids that I have had graduated and had kids or, you know, reached out to me like, hey, I need some advice on how to be a dad like you. I've watched your kids grow up almost like my brothers and sisters. You know, I want to do this right. I think it's very important that a lot of our, you know, older Black males make that connection with kids in our community. We don't have a lot of them, but the ones who are here, I encourage them to make that connection. Right. Well, honesty is the first. You know, you have to be honest. Okay, guys, there is a disconnect here. We need to have more African-American male students and teachers so that we can make a connection and have all our schools culturally diverse. There's no easier way to say it. You just have to be honest. When you're talking about stuff like that, you need to be honest. And vice versa. If we need more white male teachers, we need more white male teachers. If we need more Hispanic male teachers, we need more Hispanic male teachers. Okay? There should be no beat around the bush. Look at our student population and make sure your staff is diverse to handle your student population. Well, I'll be honest with you. I think a lot of our students are misunderstood. I think that when a taller, darker male stands up, strong, because he's been, you know, raised to be strong and carry the load and, you know, be the father figure in the household because they lack the father figure. I feel like people are intimidated by that role, but their parents raised them to be that figure and to stand up for what they think is right or wrong. I think a lot of our students may not know how to disagree appropriately sometimes because they weren't taught the skill on how to disagree appropriately. And I think that anytime a student is not doing something right, we need to do corrective teaching and teach them the behavior and not internalize students' behavior, okay? If you're a teacher, you should never internalize students' behavior. What you should do is be compassionate, caring, give the student some time and say, hey, what was that about? Can you explain to me? I want to know your version, and then I'm going to tell you what I saw there. That's how you make a connection with the student. If you're automatic get out, you're never going to solve the problem because you never got to the root of the problem. Okay? So a lot of our staff and our students have issues based on the fact that there's no relationship, and sometimes people don't know how to disagree appropriately, and a lot of people internalize things that they shouldn't internalize. The only way you can relay that message is if you team them up with a teacher that is dynamic. And that teacher makes a connection with them their last 2 years of high school. Because your last 2 years of high school is where it finally clicks in and you decide that you have to think of what's next. If you have that student, no matter, you know, female, male, whatever, make a dynamic connection with a teacher, that student will become an educator because they're looking for what to do next. And if a teacher can guide them in the right direction, like our teacher cadet program, that's very beneficial. But the person has to be dynamic and love their job and caring and compassionate, but real.